Right, a quick look at load monitoring and overload warnings. Let's just turn that off a bit. It's from the startup first. Rail mode. There we are. Axles locked. Great. Right, I've currently got 180 kilograms as my load on hook, which is the weight of the quick hitch. In front of the machine there, I have got a large weight, which weighs about 3.15 tons, and I'm about to lift that weight off the floor. Just beginning the lift now. Watch the load on hook increase. Just there. Against our capacity, which is 4.38 tonnes hydraulically limited. As the weight comes off the floor. There we go, which is the weight of the weight itself, roughly, as I say, just under 3.2 tonnes plus the weight of the quick hitch. Notice the green bar on the side there as I put the weight down. Take the weight off the boom, that disappears. As I lift it up again. Weight is off the floor. 3.4 tonnes against a capacity of 4.37 tonnes. So what I'm going to do now is slowly slew to the right hand side clockwise. See the angle of slew just in there. Currently I've still got a hydraulic limit on the capacity. There you go. As I've got to this point of 30 degrees roughly over the side, my hydraulic limit is now gone. I'm now limited by stability of the machine rather than the amount of hydraulic power it's got. The capacity is now 4.1 against a load of 3.4. Continue slewing so slowly, see the capacity coming down gradually as I slew. Right, at that point, my amber lamp has come on. I'm getting an amber alert to say that I'm at 95% of my maximum safe working load. I'm going to continue slewing slowly. At this point, I am over 104%, or at 104% of my safe working load. At this point, the overload alarm is now sounding. My red LED is now on. And as we can see, I've got a number of motion cuts have been applied. I cannot slew any further to the right because that will take me further into overload. I also cannot put my dipper boom out any further. That would increase the radius and increase the overload. I cannot move the foreboom up because that would increase the overload, and I cannot move the stub boom any further back because that would increase the overload. Any arrow which is green is still available to me, so I can bring the dipper boom in, which I'll do now. That takes me away from the overload. I'll bring it back out again. The foreboom down should I wish to, or I can put the main boom down if I wish to, or I can slew to the left, which is what I'm going to do now. And as I slew to the left, my capacity rises. And the green bar graph at the front with the side has reduced down to a safe level. Let's go back into overload again. Motion cut, I can't do any more. Right, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to increase the radius. So my radius to the lifting point is 6.28. I'm going to lift up again. See my motor hook increasing. Now at this radius, my capacity is just 3.78 tonnes. I'm fairly close to it, so I've got a quite close to an amber alert. I'm going to slew slowly to the side. Already limited there, so I can't move that any further there. I'll put it back into a close radius. Radius. I'm going to gradually slew round. At that radius, I'm able to slew round. See what happens if I try to increase my radius. Move the dipper boom out. So the height and radius will increase. And the capacity will decrease as I go. Amber alert. The overload state, I can't move the tipper boom out any further, and at the same time I cannot slew any further to the right, move the forward boom up or the stub boom.